So it's very important to have a safe and clean drinking water. And the water we drink today contains high concentrations of regulated and unregulated contaminants, which could have adverse effect on human health. Current technologies that are available for water treatment are associated with major drawbacks. For example, you use chlorine to disinfect your water. Everybody knows about chlorine, right? That disinfects water. But what people don't know that sometimes you have compounds in your drinking water that could react with this chlorine and actually produce even more harmful chemicals, and we drink that. And it's also very dangerous for workers who are actually disinfecting this water to work with chlorine. So do you want to work with a poisonous gas, or do you want to work with water? What we are doing, we are pretty much using water to treat water. Right? When we apply very high voltage and we create plasma, we create lightning inside of the water, what we are pretty much doing is breaking this water molecule, which is H2O, into H and OH. And these radicals are very fast acting species. They pretty much attack everything that is in the bulk liquid and quickly recombine, and they're not active after a while. So all this happens in a nanosecond scale. Not that many research groups are working on this technology. The technology has lots of potential, and because there's so many design engineering issues with the technology, nobody has scaled it up yet. We got an EPA grant to pretty much in 4 years get this technology from nowhere to a pilot scale to be able to, for example, supply water to a small town. So I have very good graduate students who are working on the development of this reactor and to scale it up. We are still on the lab scale testing, but we made some really great breakthroughs in the reactor design, and hopefully in the next year we'll be scaling up the reactor.